You're going through OTA 7 weeks, 7 year. How much more comfortable are you, and how much easier are things?
I'm very comfortable. I wouldn't say things have gotten a lot easier, just because I'm kind of doing some nickel stuff now. So it's a different position. At the end of the day, still playing football, but as far as the thought process goes, you know, I'm doing a lot of tape study now. But confidence as far as like on the outside and just being with the guys is a lot better than last year. I feel like I belong now, and I kind of feel like that, I guess, older vet, but not really an older vet, just like year two, but I feel like I can teach the young guys some stuff about the defense, so that's great.
How different is like the calibration and approach for you with getting those nickel reps from what you would usually do on the outside?
It's a big difference, man. I'm out there making mistakes, and I'm kind of hard on myself right now about it, because I kind of wish that I could just get it right now, but it's just not happening. So just going to continue to watch tape, ask the coaches the questions, and I have guys helping me out as well. So just take it one day at a time. You know, it's just second week of OTAs, but I know by the time it really matters, I'll be where I need to be.
What's one of the biggest differences for you while you're on that spot?
The biggest difference?
Yeah, like one of the biggest differences that you're adjusting to.
Really just understanding the fronts, and understanding like where your help's at more. I feel like you have more help in the slot than you do on the outside. So understanding where your help's at, and then really just understanding like fronts and where the linebackers are going to be, when to bump, when not to bump, motion, when not to run with motion, just stuff like that.
Who are you leaning on to kind of help you through that?
Well, right now, you know, Roby was here last week, so I asked Roby a lot of questions. I know Paulson did it a little bit when he was here, when he first got here anyways. So right now I'm really just going off tape. We have correction tapes, and we have tapes of like everything being done the right way. So I'm just watching the tape, putting play calls together, and just going off trial and error. But the coaches are doing really good with helping me out, letting me know. Sterling, a guy who's played in the league, but he's also helped me on the sideline.
How open are you to that challenge or kind of a change at this point?
I'm open to it, but at the end of the day, I'm still a corner. I don't feel like I've shown that I can't play the position, but I don't think the coaches feel that way either. I feel like they're just trying to introduce me to something new and just kind of see what I can do with it. Just because, you know, game plan wise, I may end up having to travel a guy who's a slot receiver one day. So Coach Woods is big on, you know, his corners, knowing how to play the slot, but also playing the outside. So I'm open to it, like I said, but I feel like I'm still competing for the outside corner job, and that's still my number one priority.
Why the jersey number change?
So, obviously, I've always wanted a single digit in high school, had single digit, college had a single digit. Coming to the league, I didn't really care. I knew I didn't have too much say-so into that. But when 27 was open, I felt like that was the best two-digit number. But whenever one got open, I was like, okay, one's open, and they opened up zero. So I was like, okay, I'm going to get zero. Nobody's had it, kind of build my own legacy. 27 kind of has his legacy already written to it. And so I didn't get zero, I ended up just going to one. And one's a little bit deeper for me. One reason is the reason I do everything for my grandma. She passed in 09. So she's like the reason I do everything. Me and my cousin always say one reason. So it's deeper than just a swagger and, you know, kind of looking good out there. But yeah, I just wanted a single digit.
You talked about legacy. Like, what is the legacy that you want to build here?
I feel like I'm still working on that. You know, I just want everybody to know that, you know, I can be the next Marshawn, if not the better Marshawn. But like I said, my own legacy, my own way, just the way I play the game. You know, I'm trying to get more involved into the community. I feel like, you know, New Orleans has a lot to offer that I haven't got to see yet. So working on just kind of getting into the community just so people can know me outside of, you know, the helmet and just the hard-hitting safety or a corner. So, yeah.
What's some of your early impressions on Joe Woods? You mentioned him a little bit earlier.
He's very detailed. He's big on technique, and that's what I like. I think technique is probably the most important thing, especially as a corner. So that, and then, you know, him and Coach Emerald, they work together really well as far as in the meeting room, on the practice field. So far, so good. Like I said, I can't wait for everybody else to get back, though, so we can have a full group together and just see kind of how we work.
What's it like to have, you've got Dennis Allen, you've got Marcus Robertson, you've got Joe Woods, these are all secondary specialty guys. What's it like to have that amount of representation on the coaching staff for your position?
It's huge. You know, they all have been around great players. They all know what it takes to be like some of the best like in your position. So it's big, but at the end of the day, I always say, you know, I love playing for Coach DA. Just the swagger that he wants from us. And we talked about swagger last year going into the Raiders game, and you had practice already, and he's like, we need the handshakes, we need like guys dancing, moving around. It's good to play for a coach who lets you be yourself, and just plays hard-nosed defensive football. And, you know, Coach Woods has success being a D coordinator, and so just looking forward to what it looks like going into vet camp when everybody's here, and then also when we get into camp, just when it's hot, you know, and just seeing like the who gets mad, who doesn't get mad, because that heat kind of changes you up a little bit. So, yeah.